Welcome to ActonTV. My name is Joe Loblundo from Twin Seafood. We have a store in Concord, and we also have a store in Acton. We are here today with the Acton Women's Club. This is our third annual cooking show with them, and we're very excited to do that. We enjoy having them in the crowd, as long as we don't have any hecklers. That's all good. So I told the hecklers to get in the back row, but I don't know if they did. I think I might have a problem with the ladies in the front row. But today we're gonna do a wedge salad to start, which is just a nice wedge of iceberg lettuce, which I have here. We're gonna make our own blue cheese dressing, which is just a simple one. It's called blue cheese dressing for dummies, which is perfect for me. It's just a little bit of heavy duty mayonnaise, some sour cream, some crumbled blue cheese, a little bit of lemon juice, a little bit of crushed black pepper. And then at the end, if the consistency is a little bit thick, we're gonna add just a little bit of milk to reduce that down. That'll be our starting course. After that, we're gonna do a mushroom risotto that we'll do on top of the stove with a chicken stock to start, arborio rice, which is that nice, heavy, heavy Italian rice. You can also use it to make sushi, but it's that very sticky rice. It's delicious. A little bit of onion, mushrooms, like I say, and grated cheese. Of course, grated cheese goes in everything. Doesn't matter, you know, your breakfast cereal, whatever. It's all good. Typically, we cook with a lot of garlic, but today we're not using garlic today, which is kind of amazing. Just in case you ladies have a date later on or something like that, you know, you don't want to have that garlic smell on your breath. And then for the main dish, we're going to do some paired seared salmon fillet. I brought a whole salmon fillet. I'm going to skin it. We're going to take out the pin bones and show you how to do that. And then we're going to pan sear it just quickly in a very hot skillet. And we are going to roast it in the oven. So that's what we're going to have for lunch today. And hopefully everybody brought their appetite, because we got plenty of food. All right. So I think what we'll do is we'll start with the blue cheese dressing. We have some heavy duty mayonnaise here, which is what we use. We don't use anything light. So if anybody's on a diet, forget it. You're in trouble. You can see that my brother made sure to note on a sheet of paper that there's 38 calories per serving. But my opinion is that doesn't matter all that much. Just eat what you like. So we got about a cup of mayonnaise in here. We're going to add about a cup of sour cream, just regular sour cream. You can use low-fat sour cream if you'd like, but again, doesn't matter. So we're gonna do that. Mix the mayo and the sour cream together. A whisk always is easier than using a spoon or a fork. A stainless steel bowl is nice too, rather than something plastic, because it just mixes easier and nicer. And then we're gonna add a little bit of cracked black pepper, as much, you know, you can do this to taste as much as you like or don't like. Me, I'm not a real big fan of pepper, so I'm just gonna put a little bit, and when you have your salad, you can add to that as much as you like. And just a little bit of coarse salt. Not a lot, very little. We're gonna take a lemon, we'll quarter it. Good sharp knife, always a plus. And we're gonna squeeze that lemon into the mayonnaise and the sour cream. If you have a little bit of a sifter like this, it's always nice to use. Or you can always wrap the lemon in a piece of cheesecloth, just so you don't get the seeds in there. So I'm gonna squeeze the juice from a whole lemon in here. And if you have a lemon that has a thick skin, if you take it and roll it, just on a cutting board, you just take it and roll it like this here. You know, it loosens up the pulp and it makes it much easier to squeeze. I see everybody shaking their head. I guess I'm not telling you anything you don't know here. I'm trying. I'm doing what I can do. But we're gonna mix that lemon juice in. And that's a pretty good consistency right now. Looks good anyway. And then we're just gonna add a half a cup of crumbled blue cheese. You know, just anything that you can buy at the supermarket, Idlewild, whichever you like. So that's a real simple blue cheese dressing, like I say, blue cheese dressing for dummies. And then we're gonna move over to this side here, and we're gonna do just a wedge salad. So, you know, for a lot of salads, people like to use romaine lettuce or any other kind of lettuce, but for a wedge, you want to use iceberg. Now, iceberg contains a lot of water, you know, so it is a little bit of a watery lettuce, but for this here application, you definitely want to have iceberg lettuce. It's much better for a wedge. And the easiest way, so iceberg lettuce always has a core in it, so if you just slam it on the table, and you'll be able to pull that core right out. Comes right out. Nice and easy. So we'll typically for a wedge salad, you'll cut that iceberg lettuce into quarters. You'll notice this on the menu at, you know, quite a few fancy restaurants. Me, yep, the Capitol Grill. Absolutely, it's delicious. You know, I think it's my favorite salad because I love bacon. Everything's better with bacon anyways, right? So that doesn't matter. Peanut butter and bacon, anything, delicious. So I'm just gonna try to find a, there we go. So you just plate your iceberg lettuce, nice. You dress it with your blue cheese dressing. Me, I like a lot. Get it along the sides. Make sure you got plenty on there. I don't know if that's even enough for me. But you can see the blue cheese in there. It's nice and loaded with that crumbled blue cheese. You know, you gotta have that. And then we just top it with some crushed bacon bits, real bacon now. I fried this at the store this morning. I had to have a couple of pieces, you know, but that's the way that goes sometimes. And then just some nice chopped tomatoes on top. That's your wedge salad. Nice and simple. It's delicious. You may need a little bit of extra blue cheese dressing on the side, and maybe a little bit more bacon. Maybe a nice piece of crusty bread with that. But my opinion, that's my favorite salad. I think it's delicious. And the iceberg lettuce is perfect for that. Thank you. I think we'll take a little bit of a break now, and we will do the risotto. So ladies, if you'd like to have a salad in between, please feel free to come on up and we'll make that for you. But we'll be back.
Okay, welcome back to the Codfather. We're now gonna go into our side dish, the risotto. So it's gonna be a mushroom onion risotto that's gonna be served underneath the seared salmon. So we're gonna start off with a little bit of butter, and I need a knife. Can I use one of those knives?
Absolutely.
Thank you. All right, so we're gonna put 2 tablespoons of butter in.
2 tablespoons.
Roughly. 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Yeah, 1/4 pound, you know, 2 tablespoons. What do you expect, right? Okay, this is gonna be about 1/2 cup of chopped onion. Yeah, that's about right. About a half a cup of chopped mushrooms.
You know, that's the Italian way, you know? Everything is a pinch of this and a pinch of that.
You do it to taste, right?
That's why, you know, we can't bake at all. way too many rules in baking. Way too many rules.
Yeah, you have to follow the instructions. Forget about it.
It's no good. I'm gonna just.
I don't know if you guys have ever made risotto. It's not like boiling rice. It's kind of you put it in the pan, you let it sear a little bit with the vegetables, and then you slowly add in the liquid. We're gonna add in a chicken stock, and here is the risotto right here. So we're gonna let that kind of brown up a little bit. And so with risotto, instead of, like with regular rice, you add 1 cup of rice, 2 cups of water. With risotto, it's 1 cup of risotto, 3 cups of liquid. And a lot of times you'll use either a chicken stock or, I was gonna use a fish stock, but I was afraid you guys might be too much fished out. So this, with the chicken stock, will be a little bit more mild.
And you add the liquid slowly.
Yeah.
So you add 1 cup of chicken stock, 1 cup of the arborio rice, and then you let that just soften, and all that water, the first cup of chicken stock needs to get absorbed, and then you add the second cup of stock, let that get absorbed, and then you add your third cup of stock and let that get absorbed.
All right, so now we're just gonna let this saute for about a minute. The risotto's in there, the rice is in there. Gonna saute a little bit, just maybe about a minute or so, and then we're gonna add the first cup of chicken stock. So as you add it in, the first cup and all 3 cups really, is you're gonna kind of stir it in, let it go for about, you know, maybe a minute or so, and then you stir in the second cup. You kind of want to let it absorb a little bit. So there, that's going to tamp it down a little bit. That's good. I think that's okay. So that's going to kind of like cook for a little bit, maybe about a minute or so. And you know what's nice about the risotto is it's really, really moist rice, you know, so, and you can put anything over it. I mean, I've done it with chicken. I've done it with haddock. We're doing it today with salmon. I've had it with scallops. It's good. Whatever you really put on, so you could put it with like slices of beef tenderloin on it. Anything you want, it's really good. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit of just salt and pepper. Go ahead.
Just make sure that you put plenty of cheese.
Yeah.
You gotta have plenty of cheese.
Cheese. My mother's Sicilian, and she says I love cheese so much I put it on my cereal.
Delicious.
She actually says that. I don't know.
Yeah.
But
you have
all right.
To I
have, no, just once.
Believe your mom.
Everything she says.
Yep. Absolutely. No question.
All right, so that's starting to
boil
up.
When we were younger, we really didn't have a choice.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna add in the second cup.
I'm gonna stir that a little bit for you.
Add in the second cup.
That smells delicious.
Yeah, it's good.
Doesn't that smell good?
You can smell it over there?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
So that's the second cup.
And then we'll add a little bit of salt. It's about a tablespoon of salt. Now that's not even close to a tablespoon.
Is that kosher salt or sea salt?
That's kosher salt right there, yeah. And that's gonna cook. So that's gonna cook. I'll add the third cup in a little bit, and we'll let that thing cook. Right now, Joe's gonna go over how you bone a salmon, take the pin bones out, and then how to like take off the skin, how to fillet off the skin. So go for that. I'll let this cook.
All right. So we have a beautiful piece of farm-raised salmon. So now you know the whole thing about farm-raised and wild and all that stuff there. Either one is delicious. The wild salmon tends to have a little bit of a stronger flavor. So we chose to use farm raised today only because we didn't know if everybody liked that strong flavor or whatnot. Also, the farm raised has a little bit more of a fat content, which
I thought you were going to say something different.
I almost did. I almost did. It has a little bit more of a fat content.
Whatever.
So it has more omega-3 in it, which is good for you. Anyway, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take the skin off. You can see that the skin is on the backside. It's all scaled. We're gonna take the skin off first. Now, a trick to do this if you're gonna do it at home is I'm gonna do the whole piece at once. It's obviously easier if you do sections at a time, but if you take some water and put it on your cutting board and get the thinnest knife that you have in the drawer, okay? So you want a thin knife because you want it to literally bend, okay? Because you're going to press against the board. This might get a little messy here, but that's okay. So you want to start at the tail end.
You might get a little bit of salmon flung at you, but don't worry about it. It doesn't really hurt.
You want to start at the tail end here, get the knife up underneath, right? Good sharp knife. And then you want to grab this and pull.
Nice.
Right? Nice and easy. So the key to doing this, you can see that there's no meat on there. Right? Zero. Wow.
I can't even believe it.
Right?
It's unbelievable.
So that's the key, right? Because we sell fish retail, and if we're leaving fish on the skin, we're losing money. All right? So, you know, an old timer told me a million years ago that anything that you can keep out of the barrel, you put directly in your pocket.
It makes sense.
Makes sense, right?
Definitely makes sense.
All right. So we're gonna just put that skin in there and put that to the side. Now, what we have here, John, can you put a little bit of olive oil in
this
pan?
Absolutely.
I turn that on. We want to get this pan, you know, hot so that when we put the fish in, you get a nice sear going right away.
Want me to do that?
Yeah, you want to just turn that up a little bit, maybe to like 7. So this is a induction.
Induction.
Or conduction.
I was going to say conduction.
It might be induction. Yeah, no, induction is like induction to the military, right? So it must be like conduction or something. Anyways, you need to have a special pan for these. It's induction.
It is induction.
See, it says it right there.
Oh, yeah.
Anyways, you need to have a special pan for this type of cooktop, right? And it's great. But so we're going to take out the pin bones. So you can see if you can kind of come in real close on this piece of salmon. You could see these.
Are they coming in close?
No.
No. No. No. No.
There it is.
Ah, see, there it is.
Nice job, Rick.
It's nice. That's my wedding ring right there. Okay, that was my father's. We have the same initials. Anyway, so you can see these pin bones. So I like to use these things here that the doctors use because it makes me feel like I'm a doctor.
Forceps.
What are these called?
Forceps.
Forceps?
Yeah, forceps.
No, I think these are called hemostats.
That's a hemostat?
These are hemostats.
I've been calling them forceps for like 30 years. What's a forcep look like? Oh, they're bigger, but does it clamp like that too? But it's bigger, but it does clamp like that? Oh, okay.
All right, well, let me know how I do. If you need help in the emergency room, I might be able to help you out.
If you correct this again, I'm going to take that thing and clip it on your nose. I'm only kidding.
Anyways, you can just, you know, you can use tweezers. Right. But these are nice because it's just easy to handle. So you just, you know, the pin bones are right here. So you want to just pull them out. You can see how nice and easy they come out. Because, you know, people, they come to your house for dinner. They don't want to have bones in their fish, you know.
But if you don't have a hemostat, it's tough to do it. Now I need to memorize that. But they're really tough to take out if you don't have something that can clamp down on them. Like a pair of tweezers don't work.
No. So in salmon, it's called what they call a floating rib cage. So like when you cut like cod or haddock or something like that, you can take all the bone out with no problem. But in a salmon, the rib cage actually runs all the way to the outside of the fish. So it's only in one line You can see that it just runs right down this line here, and it stops about halfway down the fillet. So we're just going to pull out all these bones.
And there's this fallacy about omega-3. Oh, you got to eat the wild salmon to get omega-3. I'm telling you, roughly it's about the same whether you have a wild piece of salmon like a piece of king salmon from the West Coast or a piece of Atlantic farm-raised salmon. Roughly all Atlantic salmon is farm-raised, and they raise it anywhere from up in Maine all the way up into Canada.
Yeah, so you know, the omega-3 is found in the, it's in the fat. It's in the fat content, so, you know. Okay, so that's pretty much, that's boneless. There are some, you can see all these bones. See? You don't want to, you know, those things get caught in your throat or whatever. And then right at the very tip of the fish, there's usually some bones too, so I like to just chop that off. And then, so this here white part here is the belly of the fish, and I'll trim that out because there are some bones in there as well. You know, it's just, you know, you got to have a nice sharp knife and you can get through it, trim out the bone.
That's hard to do. Like if you're trying to do that at home, that's hard to do. You need an ultra sharp knife, almost like a razor sharp. But if you look at this salmon, this is a farm-raised salmon. You can see the fat lines here in the fish. And if you have a wild salmon, the fat lines in the wild salmon aren't as distinctive as in the farm-raised salmon.
No, because the wild salmon gets much more exercise, right?
Right? Yeah. They do.
They're out there jogging around.
They're trying to fight their way up the river. You know, they're trying to fight their way up the river. This guy's just sitting in a pen hanging out.
They're chasing the female salmon.
Yeah.
All that stuff.
It takes time. Yeah, it takes effort.
You don't have to chase them. That's right. They get them quick. All right, so we got a little bit of olive oil in here, right? And it's nice and hot. You know, you don't want to stick your hand in there, but, you know, you want to feel so that it's nice and hot. And we're just going to cut a couple of pieces of the salmon.
Beautiful.
And you can see on the backside, you got this little bit of brown here. Now, some people don't like that. Right, but that's a little bit of a, like if you have a piece of swordfish, you know the bloodline on the swordfish? Well, it's very similar to that. So it's a little bit, it's a little gamier, you know, in flavor. It's a richer flavor. You can trim that off if you like. Personally, I like it.
It kind of cooks off too. A lot of it will cook off.
So I'm going to leave that on there. John made a nice little what's in here?
In that's a marinade. It has soy sauce, garlic, sesame oil, sesame seeds, orange juice, and then a little bit of pepper. That's it. And a little bit of garlic. Did I say garlic powder? Yeah, okay. And that's it. It's simple, it's good, it has a sesame flavor, it's perfect, it's a little bit sweet, because salmon's good when it's a little salty, a little sweet. So I think it'll be perfect for the salmon. And we put it on the stuff inside.
So I'm just going to brush a little bit on. You can marinate the salmon prior to, if you'd like. Personally, fish is very, very porous. So, you know, my feeling is when you marinate fish for too long, you lose the flavor of the fish completely. All you taste is the marinade. And you know, if you're gonna marinate something and you want to have the marinade, use chicken, you know?
Another thing is, like, if say you don't necessarily like salmon. I don't know if some people out there don't necessarily like salmon. Some people like it. It's a little bit fishier than say like a piece of cod. If you wanted it just to get yourself to eat it more, you can marinate it a little bit more. You know, with something that you really like. If you like salmon,
because it is really good for you.
Yeah, I mean the omega-3 is key. I mean the omega-3 is good for your heart, your cholesterol, your skin, your hair. It's like. It's a wonderful.
It's amazing. You guys should be eating salmon every day.
Yeah.
Stores open every day.
We have it. Yeah, we have it every day.
7 days a week.
We can cut you a nice piece.
You know? So you can see that's nice and hot. You'll hear it.
Nice.
Sizzle right up.
Yep.
And we're just going to put a couple of pieces in there. And I always use a nonstick pan I just think it's so much easier, you know, if you have a good nonstick pan. Now, I don't know if you guys watch the cooking shows on TV, but they always use that copper pan, right? Do you have one?
Oh, you have one?
Is it good? I'm thinking they slide right out, right?
Wow.
Yeah.
Can I show these guys something?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, so do you guys ever buy salmon steaks? That's when you take the whole fish and you cut a cross section of the fish. And it's bony, right? You ever have it? It's bony? Okay, here's a trick. All right, next time you're in, you take a fillet like this, you do exactly what Joe did. You bone it and you take the skin off, you cut it. So if, say you want your salmon steak about, say, an inch thick. You cut it 2 inches, okay? Then you turn it, and then you cut it down the middle, but you don't cut it all the way through.
Basically, you're butterflying it.
You butterfly it, and then when you turn it, let me see if that's enough. Yeah, that's about right. And then you turn it, and you have a boneless salmon steak that's beautiful. Bang!
All right, so you want to get a nice sear on this, so you can see. See how nice that is? I'm going to show you guys that. Can you see that? So it just sears up really nice. And by searing it, it's kind of like, you know, like in the nice restaurants when they do steaks, this is what they do. Right? So they sear off the piece of meat real quick to keep all the juices in. And then they roast it in a very high temperature until, you know, if you want it medium rare or medium or what, however you like it. But it's the same idea with the salmon, right? So you want to sear this off nice and quick, but you can see on the sides that it's really, you know, it's not cooked all the way through, right?
Right.
So you want to just keep that, and that's why the nonstick pan is nice, because the fish just moves around nicely. You can season it with a little bit more marinade, you know, just a little brush.
And real quick, this risotto's done, and it absorbed that one cup, absorbed all 3 cups without a problem. So that stuff's ready to rock.
Delicious.
And roll.
And then what you do with this here, you let that sift for just a little bit so that it firms up nice. And then you take it and you put it in on a, you can do it on a cookie sheet, or you can do it in just a baking pan, whatever you like. You take it, preheat your oven to about 400 degrees, nice and high, right? And just a couple of pieces like that, you put it in the oven, it's gonna take about 8 minutes, 400 degrees. The juice is all sealed, nice inside, and it's done. And you know, it's a quick meal. It's nice and easy on top of the stove, in the oven quick, and you're done.
We made a nice hots of lettuce with a homemade blue cheese dressing, homemade bacon bits, and garnished it with a little bit of tomato. Beautiful. Okay, this is the risotto. It's a mushroom onion risotto. We made it with a little bit of chicken stock, butter and oil, and it's just beautiful, and it's gonna play nicely with the salmon.
Yeah, and this is a farm-raised salmon. We pan-seared it quickly. You saw that it took about maybe 3 minutes on a side. You get a nice crust on there. Then you put it in a hot oven, and you roast it at about 400 degrees for approximately 8 minutes. This is set on a bed of the risotto, and you got a beautiful, nice, healthy meal here.
We made you this dinner you can't refuse. All right. Thank you.